The situation further in Mosul. We're joined here by award-winning journalist Martin Jay. Martin, thanks for joining us here on RT. If we look at the people returning to their hometown now, in your opinion, how long will it take them? Could it take them to rebuild their lives and the city?
Who knows? I mean, we're looking at possibly months or even the best part of a year before most of those people return. But return to what? You know, I mean, if you look at most of the old city in Mosul is completely destroyed. So, you know, we're looking at new parameters, completely off the scale measures now, which will have to be undertaken by humanitarian groups and aid agencies on the ground to cope with something like hundreds of thousands of people who will be in dire need of shelter and healthcare and so forth.
Yeah, it's not a quick fix, is it, to rebuild their lives and to rebuild the city? The UN are also fearing that some people may be trapped in areas with pockets of ISIL resistance. What are the real chances of them being safely liberated as well?
Slim. I mean, we've seen in the past that this is a tactic of war, unfortunately, by ISIL to shamefully use these people, these innocent people, as pockets, as buffers, as literally human shields for the ordnance, which is flying backwards and forwards. So it's their destiny is a rather sad and uncertain one, unfortunately. But as was alluded before, I think by somebody else in your report and by a British general today in the press, you know, war is incredibly ugly, and the sort of warfare now that we're experiencing in Iraq and Syria has moved on from the days of just a few years ago when American soldiers in Afghanistan were chasing around groups of Taliban and effectively moving them from one region to the other. We've advanced from that. And I think that's what was alluded to by someone previously, that now it's to a different level. And when people are using human shields to actually fight, then, of course, radical measures have to be met by radical measures.
Yeah, I mean, you say radical measures have to be met by radical measures, but the liberation doesn't necessarily mean that it will be safe or the fighting has completely stopped. At a latest briefing, the coalition, they've announced that they might establish bases in Iraq to finish the fight. They're suggesting that the fighting isn't over by that, aren't they?
Oh, it's not completely over, no. There's still pockets of it left to be done. But the situation from America has completely changed in the last couple of weeks towards this idea of whether they keep soldiers in Western Iraq or not. The original idea was they wouldn't. And this sparked a certain amount of interest from the European Union that had its ideas about having its new, shiny, squeaky, clean new EU army there. NATO always were looking at a certain contingent. So the Americans have done a sort of sea change there, and I think that's probably because a lack of communication between Trump, the White House, the Pentagon, and the State Department. But the other idea, I mean, the other thing you have to consider is that when you take a city like Mosul and you take it in the way that it has been taken, you are essentially sowing the seeds of insurgency in the longer term anyway. You know, when you look at the sheer numbers, the horrific numbers of people who died just because they were human fodder to be used as a shield for ISIS, and a Western-backed Iraqi army which didn't seem to care at all about the sort of the numbers, the scale of 50, 60, 70 innocent people to be killed just for one ISIS fighter, and in some cases, not even to kill one ISIS fighter. So in the longer term, I think we're looking at another war, another battle, another conflict with new groups. People will be signing up to ISIS or whoever takes over from ISIS, but you can't really say that the battle is over in Mosul.
Yeah, Martin, the picture that you're painting looks pretty grim, but obviously there's some truth in it when people are looking into the issues there. Thank you so much. So much to talk about, but thanks very much for joining us here on RT. That's award-winning journalist Martin Jay.